theater contributor Paul Leary takes a peek at Broadway's blockbuster Tony Award-winning musical, now on stage at the Arsht.
The Lion King was Disney's 32nd animated feature and the most successful film of 1994. It has inspired thousands of fans, and now it's the most eagerly awaited production to leap onto the stage. Visually stunning, technically astounding, and a musical score like none you've ever heard. The story of The Lion King takes place in the fictional Pride Lands of Africa, where a lion rules over the other animals as king. It tells a coming-of-age story, and as the song says, about the circle of life. Giraffes are strutting, birds swoop, gazelles leap. The entire animal kingdom comes to life on stage. You'll marvel at the breathtaking spectacle of animals brought to life by a cast of more than 40 actors. You'll wonder at the inspiration of award-winning director Julie Taymor, who created visual images for the show that you'll remember forever. With an unforgettable score including Elton John and Tim Rice's Oscar-winning song Can You Feel the Love Tonight and Circle of Life, Lion King is a theatrical musical for the whole family. Moving this behemoth show across the country is quite an undertaking, and I had the opportunity to speak with two of its actors. Later we'll hear from local girl Sharron Williams about how it feels to have her Broadway dream come true, but first I speak with the energetic actor Mark David Kaplan, who plays the easily flustered and somewhat panicky red-billed hornbill bird Zazu. Nice to speak with you, Mark.
That's me.
Tell us about The Lion King.
It incorporates everything that you probably want as a theater goer in a big show. I mean, it's grand, It sounds gorgeous, the beautiful strings, the way the show is orchestrated. And then you have the different styles of music that come into play. There's Can't Wait to Be King, that the kids kind of get to rule the roost in the first scene that I'm also involved in. And it is entirely from a young cub's perspective. And while it seems fun and it's very light, the reality is, as he goes, people who know the story, as he goes through, that lightness kind of clears the way and he has to deal with a lot of really heavy stuff, but not non-childlike stuff. So the progression of the music from light things like that to beautiful He Lives in You that Mufasa sings to his son, it's a great mix for me as somebody who enjoys the character moments. There's great lightness, and then you have the amazing, the South African chanting. The top of Act One is a glorious number where the ensemble comes through with gorgeous kites, again designed by Michael Curry, through the house. And again, you're right there as an audience member. You're in the middle of it. It's an integrated book musical in that sense. I mean, it's beautiful music, but it all has a purpose.
You're playing the character Zazu. Can you remind us where that fits into the relationship with the story?
Yes. Zazu is a bird. I am a hornbill. He is the majordomo. He is Mufasa, the king at the beginning of the play. He is the majordomo's confidant, basically his sidekick, but for all things Pride Land. And it's interesting because the way I'm delineated even visually, I'm sort of in a comparison contrast with the bird. It's shades of white and blue. And I have the very important task of taking care of the children and kind of keeping the family in check. And again, anybody who knows the story knows that that does go awry. I kind of feel like I'm a glue spot in terms of the story. I'm glue for the family to keep things together. I'm kind of the one who people can bounce things off of, and just like I am in life. I love doing it. I love working with kids. I get to work with the kids in the first act, and it encompasses all the things that I, as an actor, enjoy doing.
Oh, so, that's what I was going to ask you. How many people in this cast?
Oh, gosh. Well, the cast itself is 50 people. That's not always everybody performing on stage, but we travel with many. They are called swings, people who know ensemble parts,
right,
who come in and out, who are not performing every night. We have standbys for the principal roles. So all told, that's 50 people, but on any given night, it's over 40 people that you see on stage.
And does that include the kids, too, that you mentioned?
Yeah, that includes the kids. We have two sets of kids, actually. In the first act, Simba and Nala are 9, 10-ish in the play, and our kids are 9, 10-ish, too, so that works out. We do 8 shows a week, and each set of kids does 4 shows. Because these kids are living on, you talk about life on the road, they're living on the road with their families or guardians. They're being tutored on the road. They're having to live their real life, and hopefully the real life that we all knew growing up. That's going to be tough. That can be challenging. But try to keep things as normal as possible for them.
Oh, that's interesting. So they bring tutors and stuff to keep their studies up. That's good.
We have a lot of families in the show anyhow, who with their kids who are not in the show. We have a great community of people who are together. So it does become a large extended family where the kids in the show get to know the children of people performing in the show and otherwise. It's great. Kind of turns out to be, you wouldn't think that it would be that normal staying 4 and 5 weeks in one city, but you get there, you find the good places, there's stuff to do, and they take field trips. They go to nearby museums, and they actually incorporate that into their schoolwork.
That's great. We're going to speak with a member of the Lion King touring family with a local connection in just a moment. Mark, it was a pleasure.
Paul, thank you. I appreciate it.
Sharron Williams is part of the ensemble, and she is from Miami and a high school graduate of New World School of the Arts. She was a member of the Ailey 2 and Spectrum Dance Theater. She also works as a model and holds 2 BA degrees from Florida State University, one in applied economics and the other in interdisciplinary social science. With those degrees, it just makes sense to want to be touring in a Broadway show. Sharron Williams is fresh out of dance class, and she joins me now. Thanks for talking to me.
Thank you for having me.
Oh, it's so nice to talk to you. It's nice to talk to one of Miami's own who's doing so well and touring in The Lion King. Wanted to talk about your experience. How long have you been with the show?
I've been with the show, actually, 2 years today. I just realized that.
Oh, congratulations.
2 years today, yep.
You're part of the ensemble, and tell us about some of the parts that you play.
I'm a dancer in the show. My main specialty is the cheetah, which I absolutely adore and love that part. I have about 13 costume changes throughout the show. So as an ensemble member, we all play a variety of parts. So the women, we are all going to be a lioness at least 2 or 3 times throughout the show. We're a part of this piece called Grasslands, where you're a piece of grass, basically. You're a hyena. You are a wildebeest. You change into a variety of costumes, and you transform into all these different characters throughout the show. And it's super, super cool. There's just as much choreography and things that you see on the stage. There's just as much behind the scenes, getting in and out of costumes, in and out of makeup for the different scenes in the show. And that's pretty much the case with any ensemble member. We all play a variety of parts.
A lot of quick changes and things like that, yeah. Mm-hmm. And this is a big cast. There's like 40 people in this cast or something?
Yep. A little over 40 people,
yeah.
And we travel with a little over 100 people, and that includes the cast and crew. And it's a big deal. It's a lot of us that travel together, and everyone does their part so well, on stage and off stage, and everyone's part is just as important as, you know, when it comes to making the show come together every single night, 8 shows a week, city after city, year after year. Yeah, it's a pretty big deal.
It must be even bigger to be coming home to Miami.
I can't even describe to you.
Did they like all your family like buy every ticket and they're all going to be there?
I have a lot of requests so far. I put in over 20 ticket requests, and that's just through me. I have not been home for longer than a week since I graduated high school. So to come for a month, to be working, to have free time, to have them come experience this show with me that I've always wanted to do, it is an indescribable feeling that I can't even put into words. I'm super excited. It's Miami. It's a beautiful place, you know.
So this is like a dream come true, huh?
It's totally a dream come true.
Oh,
totally
that's great.
Yeah.
Well, it's Sharron Williams, and she's in the touring production of The Lion King here in Miami for 4 weeks. And thanks so much for talking to us here on WLRN.
And I'm thrilled. Thank you for having me.
For more information about show dates for The Lion King and ticket information, please visit archcenter.org. For South Florida Arts Beat, I'm Paul Leary.